morning, everybody. I will be talking about research I did for my master thesis. About camels. And although camels are, as you all know, not indigenous to Europe, there is a surprising large amount of camel finds from the Roman Empire in Central Europe and Iberia. They start from the 1st century AD to the 4th century AD. And as I use toothed animal for my study, it is important to know that there are 14 sites with teeth, including Basel, which isn't indicated on this map because the tooth was only found last year. There are both species present, so we have dromedaries, we have Bactrian camels, and we have also some indication of a hybrid camel from Turkey. But in most of the cases, this species is unknown because species identification on camels or on camels is very difficult when you only have like osteological methods. Now, what were these camels used for? There has been a little bit of research, and of course, they were used as beasts of burden in both trade and military contexts. They could also have been used in agriculture, as we have depictions of camels that were harnessed to plows, for example, from a Roman tombstone from Girsa, from Libya. We also have written evidence that they played a role in the Ludi, the Roman games. They were used in camel fights and camel races. And of course, also camel products were used. Their hair was used to create textiles. And also we have some written evidence that their meat and their milk was consumed occasionally. Now, the overall goals of the study were very generally to investigate camel husbandry in the Roman Empire. And to do this, we wanted to reconstruct their life history and their mobility pattern from a couple of camels that were found at these Roman sites in Central Europe. And with our study, also test how we can use carbon and oxygen to get an idea about mobility of these animals. As we have heard, when we're using toothed animal, we get information about the early years of a camel's life. This is a chart that shows a rough estimation which time periods the different teeth represent. I didn't sample deciduous teeth, but only permanent teeth, and these are the estimations based on tooth eruption times that we came up with. And then we use the variation in delta oxygen 18 in the water to infer differences in the climate. And as camels obtain most of the water from leaf, so from the plants they eat, I have here a picture of the global mean delta oxygen 18 values of leaf water. And we can already see that there is a decent amount of variation, even on this global scale, with much higher values in Northern Africa than in Central Asia, and of course the lowest values in Central Europe. And these are the distributions of the two camel species that are quite distinct. So we probably can also not only see where the camels come from, but maybe also get an indication about what camel species this could be. Okay, so the material I used comes from this area indicated in the right corner from Central Europe. We had four individuals from four sites, the first of which is Innsbruck-Wilten, a settlement from the 2nd to 3rd century AD, and we had the third molar and the fourth premolar. Then we have a dromedary from Luxembourg, from Mamère Bertranche, from the 3rd century AD. Here we had all three molars present from the mandible. Then another camel dromedary from the first half of the 4th century AD from Tongeren in nowadays Belgium. And the fourth one is from the second half of the 3rd century AD. Yeah, species couldn't be identified there either. And it's from Trier in Germany. All four of them were adult individuals. No cut marks were present on the bone. And all in all, I took 73 samples along the tooth crowns. The reference material are used to get a sense of different kind of habitats are indicated on this map, and they span a large area. The sites indicated in bold letters are sites where I analyzed reference material from. The other ones I used published data in the literature. Now, the research questions I wanted to address with the study was, first of all, if I can find out roughly the area where the camels originated from, and to see if the camels were all imported to Europe or if they were even bred there, because this was suggested in the literature based on some finds of juvenile camel bones in Tanais on the Black Sea shore. Yeah, and also I wanted to see if all the individuals show a similar mobility pattern or if they all behave completely differently. And in hindsight, also check if I can use my data as an additional proxy for species identification. Yeah, I took introduced serial samples along the tooth crown axis and to obtain a continuous record, and then used the data to see any shifts in the habitat. Now, this is the reference data, the mean, with plus minus one sigma. On the x-axis, we have the carbon 13, and on the y-axis, we have the oxygen 18. And we see Central Europe clearly has the lowest oxygen and carbon values, with an increase towards North Africa and Arabia, which has the highest values, which is the driest and most warm habitat. Now, where do our camels now come from? These are the M1s from three of the camels. Mame Bertrand shows a clear association to like North African habitats. In this case, it aligns with Chad. Then we have Trier, which has lower values and probably more, this doesn't originate from North Africa, but more like near to Middle Eastern area. And then Tongeren is the one, the camel that was most close to Europe, but probably not originated from Central Europe, but more like, outside of Europe, probably the Mediterranean area. But as you can see, we have kind of a gap of the reference material there, so we can't really say with confidence where this camel came from. Now I want to talk a bit about the similar migration or mobility pattern of the camel from Mamère Bertrand and Trier. They both show a continuous approximation throughout their lifetime from very warm and dry habitats towards Central European values. With Mamère Bertrand originating from Northern Africa, and the journey of the camel from Trier probably starts in the Near or Middle East. Interestingly, we can link both of them with a specific military unit, the Legio 8 Augusta. This unit was present and active in the Middle East in the 3rd century AD, and we have some written evidence. We have some inscriptions from both Trier and Mamère that proves that this military unit was also present at these two sites where the camels were found in the 3rd century AD. So probably they were picked up by this military unit and then took back to Central Europe sometime after they were 5 years old. To complete the picture, I also added the other two camels. The things are a bit more complicated here. We don't really see any shifts in diet between C3 and C4 plants for the camel from Tongeren, but we see quite a large variation of the oxygen values, which could mean that it moved from a warmer or habitat towards a more temperate one between the ages of 4 to 5 years. The camel from Innsbruck-Wilton, it doesn't show a large variation of either the oxygen or the carbon values. They are very stable, and we also don't see any sign of seasonal variation of the oxygen values, which could indicate that it moved in a way that avoided these high, just avoided seasonal temperature variation. So to conclude, we didn't find any real evidence that camels were bred at any of these four sites or in Central Europe. They originated from different sites, so there also wasn't one place where all the camels originated from and were brought to Europe. We could find a similar mobility pattern of the camels from Mamia Bertrange in Trier and link them to a military unit. And we also saw that, yeah, we can probably use it as an additional proxy for species identification, as now we can see that the individual from Trier most likely is a dromedary, as it's from the Near to Middle East. And yeah, we have quite a decent amount of variation and can get quite a lot of information about life history and mobility of these individuals. Oops. I would like to thank my collaborators and also the funding body, the Senckenberg Institute, and thank you for your attention.